Air Force Space Command (AFSPC) is a major command of the United States Air Force, with its headquarters at Peterson Air Force Base, Colorado. AFSPC supports U.S. military operations worldwide through the use of many different types of space operations. Operationally, AFSPC is an Air Force Major Command subordinate to U.S. Strategic Command (USSTRATCOM), a unified combatant command. As of 2019, it is the primary space force for the U.S. Armed Forces. More than 38,000 people perform AFSPC missions at 88 locations worldwide. They include military personnel of the regular Air Force Reserve and Air National Guard, Department of the Air Force Civilians, DAFC, and civilian military contractors. Composition consists of approximately 22,000 military personnel and 9,000 civilian employees, although their missions overlap. On 1 December 2009, the Strategic Nuclear Intercontinental Ballistic Missile (ICBM) mission that AFSPC inherited from Air Combat Command (ACC) in 1993, and which ACC had inherited following the inactivation of Strategic Air Command in 1992, was transferred to the newly established Air Force Global Strike Command (AFGSC). Topic: Mission. According to AFSPC, its mission is to provide resilient and affordable space capabilities for the Joint Force and the nation. AFSPC's primary mission areas are Space Forces support, involving the launching of satellites and other high-value payloads into space using a variety of expendable launch vehicles and operating those satellites once in space. Space control, ensuring the friendly use of space through the conduct of counterspace operations encompassing surveillance, negation, protection and space intelligence analysis. Force enhancement, providing satellite-based weather, communications, intelligence, missile warning, and navigation. Force enhancement is direct support to the warfighter. Topic: History. During the Cold War, space operations focused on missile warning and associated command and control for the National Command Authority (NCA). Missile warning operations from the former Aerospace Defense Command (ADC) that had been assumed by Tactical Air Command (TAC) in the late 1970s, and space and spacelift, space launch operations that had been resident in the Air Force Systems Command (AFSC), were combined to form a new Air Force Major Command (MAJCOM) in 1982 known as Space Command. Following the creation of United States Space Command (USSPACECOM) as a unified combatant command, in 1985, Space Command was renamed Air Force Space Command (AFSPC) and assigned to USSPACECOM as its USAF component command. In 1991, Operation Desert Storm provided emphasis for AFPSC's new focus on support to the warfighter. ICBM forces previously assigned to the inactivated Strategic Air Command (SAC) were merged into AFSPC in 1993 until moved into Air Force Global Strike Command (AFGSC) in 2009. In August 2009, Air Force Space Command became the lead MAJCOM for all Air Force cyberspace operations with the stand-up of 24th Air Force, gaining Air Force Cyber Operations and Combat Communications Units, the Air Force Network Integration Center, and the Air Force Spectrum Management Office, formerly known as the Air Force Frequency Management Agency. On 1 April 2013, Air Force Space Command announced that the Space Innovation and Development Center's missions had been realigned under Headquarters, Air Force Space Command, and the Air Force Warfare Center of the Air Combat Command (ACC). The Space Command was the subject of a 60 Minutes news segment on CBS in April 2015. When speaking with 60 Minutes reporter David Martin, Commanding General John E. Highton was not able to respond to many of the questions, claiming the information was classified but that the program was doing its part in keeping the global world of GPS satellites and other important global satellite usage peaceful. To ensure satellite safety, General Highton confirmed the belief that other countries were developing anti-satellite technology, but that the Space Command program was developing technologies of their own, including telescopic lasers to better track the paths of satellites. Reporter David Martin also asked about the new Boeing X-37 spaceplane the U.S. Air Force had been testing. General Highton confirmed that it could bring satellites into orbit and bring them back, and that the U.S. Air Force would do everything they could to protect the country and its satellites from the danger posed by anti-satellite technology from China and Russia in the future. In 2016, Space Command began their Space Mission Force concept of operations to respond quickly to attacks in space. Each space wing undergoes special training, then serves a 4 to 6 month rotation. Topic: Launch service agreements. In 2016, the U.S. Congress authorized the Air Force to sign deals with the space industry to co-finance the development of new rocket propulsion systems. The program known as the Launch Service Agreement (LSA) fits the Air Force's broader goal to get out of the business of buying rockets, and instead acquire end-to-end services from companies. The Air Force signed cost-sharing partnerships with Launch Vehicle Company (ULA), Launch Vehicle and Rocket Engine Manufacturers (SpaceX) and Orbital ATK, and with rocket engine supplier Aerojet Rocketdyne. The original request for proposals noted the Air Force wants to leverage commercial launch solutions in order to have at least two domestic, commercial launch service providers. As of March 2018, the Air Force intended to select three companies by mid-year 2018 so that the Space and Missile Systems Center could contract for launch system prototypes. Topic 2018. On July 17, 2018, 24th Air Force, along with the Cyber Mission, was moved from Air Force Space Command to Air Combat Command. Topic: List of commanders. Topic: Organization. Topic: Numbered Air Forces. Air Force Space Command has one active numbered Air Force (NAF). Topic: 14th Air Force. The 14th Air Force 14AF provides space warfighting forces to U.S. Strategic Command in its capacity as Air Force's strategic space, and is located at Vandenberg AFB, California. It is responsible for space launch, spacelift of payloads from facilities in California and Florida, and manages the generation and employment of space forces to support U.S. Strategic Command and North American Aerospace Defense Command (NORAD) operational plans and missions. Direct reporting units. AFSPC is the major command providing space forces for U.S. Strategic Command. AFSPC also supports NORAD with ballistic missile warning information, operates the Space Warfare Center to develop space applications for direct warfighter support, and is responsible for the U.S. Department of Defense's ICBM follow-on operational test and evaluation program. Topic: Space and Missile Systems Center. The Space and Missile Systems Center (SMC) at Los Angeles AFB, California, designs and acquires all Air Force and most Department of Defense space systems. It oversees launches, completes on-orbit checkouts, then turns systems over to user agencies. It supports the Program Executive Officer for Space on the NAVSTAR Global Positioning, Defense Satellite Communications and MILSTAR systems. SMC also supports the Defense Meteorological Satellite Program and the follow-on early warning system. In addition, it supports development and acquisition of land-based intercontinental ballistic missiles for the Air Force Program Executive Office for Strategic Systems. Locations. The AFSPC headquarters is a major unit located at Peterson AFB, Colorado. There are six AFSPC host bases: Buckley AFB, Colorado, 460th Space Wing, 233rd Space Group, Colorado Air National Guard, Los Angeles AFB, California, Space and Missile Systems Center, Global Positioning Systems Directorate, Space Superiority Systems Directorate, Launch Systems Directorate, Infrared Space Systems Directorate, Defense Weather Systems Directorate, Military Satellite Communications Systems Directorate, Space Logistics Directorate, Missile Defense Systems Directorate, Space Development and Test Directorate, Kirtland AFB, New Mexico, Spacelift Range and Network Systems Division, 61st Air Base Group, 61st Civil Engineering and Logistics Squadron, 61st Medical Squadron, 61st Mission Support Squadron, Patrick AFB and Cape Canaveral AFS, Florida, 45th Space Wing, 114th Space Control Squadron, Florida Air National Guard, Peterson AFB, Colorado, 21st Space Wing, 821st Air Base Group, GSU at Thule Air Base, Greenland, 20th Space Control Squadron, GSU at Eglin AFB Site C6, Florida, 310th Space Wing, AFRC, Schriever AFB, Colorado, 50th Space Wing, Space Innovation and Development Center, Vandenberg AFB, California, 14th Air Force, 30th Space Wing, 148th Space Operations Squadron, California Air National Guard. AFSPC also operates several Air Force stations for launch support and early warning missions: Cape Cod Air Force Station, Massachusetts, 6th Space Warning Squadron, Cavalier AFS, North Dakota, 10th Space Warning Squadron, Cheyenne Mountain AFS, Colorado, Cheyenne Mountain Division, Clear Air Force Station, Alaska, 13th Space Warning Squadron, 213th Space Warning Squadron, Alaska Air National Guard, Greeley Air National Guard Station, Colorado, 137th Space Warning Squadron, Colorado Air National Guard, New Boston AFS, New Hampshire, 23D Space Operations Squadron. Topic: Space capabilities. Spacelift operations, including those at the East and West Coast launch bases, provide services, facilities and range safety control for the conduct of DoD, NASA and other commercial launches. Through the command and control of all DoD satellites, satellite operators provide force multiplying effects, continuous global coverage, low vulnerability in autonomous operations. Satellites provide essential in-theater secure communications, weather and navigational data for ground, air and fleet operations and threat warning. Ground-based radar and defense support program satellites monitor ballistic missile launches around the world to guard against a surprise missile attack on North America. Space surveillance radars provide vital information on the location of satellites and space debris for the nation and the world. General Shelton has said that in order to protect against attacks, space situational awareness is much more important than additional hardening or armoring of satellites. As of 2013, Air Force Space Command was considering space disaggregation, which would involve replacing a few large multi-mission satellites with larger numbers of smaller single-purpose platforms. This could be used to defend against ASATs, by increasing the number of targets that needed to be attacked. Topic: Resources. Topic: Satellites. Advanced extremely high frequency. Defense satellite communication system. Defense meteorological satellite program. Defense support program. Fleet Satellite Communications System UHF follow-on. Global Positioning System. MILSTAR. NATO 3 and IV Communications. Space-based space surveillance. Topic: Launch vehicles. Delta 2. Atlas V. Delta 4. Topic: Space situational awareness. Air Force Satellite Control Network. Maui Optical Tracking Identification Facility. Ground-based electro-optical deep space surveillance system. Passive space surveillance system. Rapid Attack Identification Detection Reporting System. An FPS-85 Space Track Radar. Topic: Ballistic Missile Warning Radars. An FPS-115 Pave Paws. An FPS-108 Cobra Dane. An FPQ-16 Perimeter Acquisition Radar Characterization System (PARCS). Sea-based X-band radar. Sea-based X-band radar. Ballistic Missile Early Warning System (BMEWS). Topic: See also. List of government space agencies. United States Space Surveillance Network. United States Space Force. Comparable organizations. United States Army Space and Missile Defense Command. Naval Network Warfare Command, U.S. Navy.